If your application requires a highly stable temperature sensor with the highest level of accuracy, repeatability, and nearly linear output across its entire temperature range, chances are you're in the market for a resistance temperature detector, or RTD. RTDs typically use three different wiring configurations, and in this video, we'll unravel the mystery of two-wire, three-wire, or four-wire RTDs. To understand the reasoning behind each wiring configuration, first we need to understand what an RTD is and how it works. RTDs use either a platinum, nickel, or copper element, whose resistance changes in a precise and predictable manner with fluctuations in temperature. This change in resistance is then used to correlate a temperature reading. But when you bring on longer lead wires, or connectors that inherently add more resistance to the circuit, there's going to be an adverse effect on an RTD's accuracy. So there must be some way to compensate for that added resistance. And that's where the different wiring configurations come into play. Two-wire configuration. The two-wire RTD configuration is the simplest among the RTD circuit designs. In this serial configuration, a single lead wire connects each end of the RTD element to the monitoring device. Because the resistance calculated for the circuit includes the resistance between wires and connectors, as well as the resistance in the RTD element, the result will always contain some degree of error. To help minimize that error, a larger gauge lead wire is recommended. Three-wire configuration. The three-wire RTD configuration is the most commonly used RTD circuit. A three-wire RTD has a redundant lead wire that's used to measure how much resistance the wire itself is creating, then subtracts the difference so that only the resistance of the RTD element is read by the system and not that of the wire. Hence, in a three-wire RTD circuit, wire gauge and length is negligible unless there's a very long wire run, then a transmitter is recommended. Four-wire configuration. A four-wire RTD fully isolates the resistance of the RTD element from the resistance of the wire. This configuration is the most complex and thus the most time-consuming and expensive to install, but it produces the most accurate results. Its four-wire bridge design fully compensates for all resistance found in the lead wires or the connectors between them, which is why four-wire RTD configurations are primarily used in laboratories and other settings where great accuracy is necessary. And like the three-wire configuration, in cases where there's a long wire run, a transmitter is recommended. And here's a pro tip. If your end device, either a meter, controller, or transmitter, only accepts a two-wire RTD, but you're using a three- or four-wire RTD, then connect only two of the wires from either side of the RTD element. And if your end device accepts a four-wire RTD, but you're using a two- or three-wire RTD, you can use jumpers to complete the connection to the end device. So there you have it. If you want to learn more about RTDs, follow the link in the description or contact one of our engineering experts at omega.com. Thanks for watching and be sure to like and subscribe.